Machine learning has made great advances, but doesn't have much in common with the way your brain works. For artificial intelligence to evolve into its next phase, artificial general intelligence, we must examine the capabilities and limitations of biological neurons and how these relate to machine learning. In this final video in this series, I'd like to summarize the ideas presented in the previous 8 episodes.
Future AI. Technologies that think.
Overall, the inescapable conclusion is that machine learning is not very much like a brain. In fact, a neural network consisting of things called neurons connected by things called synapses is about the limit of the similarity. The signals are different, the time scale is different, and the algorithms of machine learning are impossible in biological neurons for a number of reasons. Neurons are so slow relative to a computer that the way they work is fundamentally different. Sure, there are lots of interconnected neurons and they run in a generally parallel process like the idea of artificial neural networks, but there are some obviously serial processes like vision and hearing, and the neuron slowness puts pretty hard limits on the number of stages possible in processing. If you can see or hear something and react to it in a fraction of a second, the number of processing layers in the brain is limited by the speed with which each layer can do its processing. The slow speed of processing in your brain also means that the huge training sets common in machine learning are implausible in a biological setting. The orderly layer structure of artificial neural networks is necessary to their operation. If signals from downstream layers are allowed to loop back to earlier layers, the fundamental backpropagation algorithm breaks down because the network's gradient descent surface is no longer constant. Looping connections give a neural network a degree of internal memory, so it has the capability of producing different results from identical inputs based on its internal state. This is great for the idea of more human-like thought processes, but not so good for a feed-forward artificial neural network. The algorithm of the perceptron is different and incompatible with what we know about biological neurons. The most basic summation performed by perceptrons doesn't work for neurons except in certain instances. The neuron's refractory period, about 3 milliseconds after every spike is emitted, will make neurons miss incoming spikes, and this leads to erroneous summations. In episode 5, I showed that the summation of 6 plus 1 always yields 6. Not 7, as the summation would suggest. In fact, the only situations where summation is reliable is in networks which are too slow with values too limited to be useful. In general, the idea that the value of a perceptron represents the spiking frequency of a biological neuron simply doesn't work. Machine learning relies on reasonably precise neuron values and synapse weights, neither of which is plausible in a biological setting. I showed that the more precisely a neuron value needs to be represented, the slower each network layer must run. A reasonable estimate of the number of different values represented in a neuron would be about 10, not the floating point numbers typical of artificial neural networks. Setting precise synapse weights is even worse. While some theoretical approaches to setting synapse weights might be useful, the observed biological data shows that synapse weights have a high degree of randomness. So high that I am led to believe that synapses are essentially digital, representing a weight of 0 or 1, and any intermediate values only indicate the confidence that that digital value is correct, and or how easily that particular data item might be retained or forgotten. In my mind, the biggest problem with the idea that machine learning is like your brain is that backpropagation needs to set specific synapses to specific weights. As far as we know, there is no biological mechanism by which this might be possible. Synapse weights do change in response to near concurrent spiking of the neurons they connect, but the infrastructure needed to set any specific synapse would require several neurons, obviating the value of storing information in synapse weights at all. Finally, the incredible low power needed by the human brain comes primarily from the fact that neurons in your brain don't spike very often, once every 2 seconds on average. With these low firing rates, there is no possibility that your brain is represented by the more or less continuous firing represented by artificial neural networks. Sure, the more recent neuromorphic field has made some progress in the right direction, but for the most part, it still relies on backpropagation and setting specific synapse weights, neither of which is plausible. Taken together, and in combination with other issues presented in this series, these things mean that machine learning isn't much like a brain. While machine learning has made some remarkable advances, at Future AI, we are pursuing development of a self-adaptive graph structure, a system which has been shown to be possible in neurons and could be representative of how artificial general intelligence will be implemented. We're implementing an artificial entity, Sally. She uses a remote sensory pod to learn about her environment, build an internal mental model, and learn new actions to achieve her goals. You can help the project by visiting our website and signing up to participate in the Sally beta test later this year. This concludes our Machine Learning is Not Like Your Brain series. With that in mind, what would you like to see next from this channel? Let us know in the comments below. And as always, thanks for watching.